I finally finished putting this together. It's only been about a year, but I hate abandoning a project. So without further ado, commence crappier quality footage starting now. The sink is officially a piece of shit. I'd like to take a moment and talk about how we packed for this trip. We wanted to have a setup that would allow us the flexibility to pick up and go very, very easily. So what did we pack? Well, we deliberately packed extremely light. Everything that we have are compartmentalized into four smaller organizer bags. I have one for clothes. I brought one lightweight windbreaker, one pair of jeans, a pair of shorts, a wool long sleeve shirt, two pairs of wool boxers, two wool t-shirts, and two pairs of wool socks. So wool is a miracle fabric. It breathes easy when you're hot, it keeps you warm when you're cold, it doesn't retain odor, and it dries very fast. So moving on, I have one bag for electronics. There's a portable hard drive, an iPhone cable, hard drive cable, laptop charger, and a wall adapter. I also have a bag for just random small things. We have a silk sheet for sleeping, insect repellent, sunblock, and assorted pills and medicines. In various compartments, I have a 17-inch MacBook Pro, a travel wallet, my trusty Nook e-reader, Represent, playing cards, cheap sunglasses, an eye mask, earplugs, both extremely important, and flip-flops. Lastly, I have one bag for toiletries. That's pretty self-explanatory. All these things go into a small 25-liter backpack. That's about the size backpack that we would carry around in elementary school back in the day. Packing this light allows us to easily get into the groove of dropping into a destination and unloading quickly so that we can get outside and do all the fun stuff. And that's pretty much our packing gear in a nutshell. And now comes our favorite part, bargaining for a ride to the next place.
To Ubud?
Yeah.
How much?
Ubud city or?
Central Ubud.
Central Ubud.
Oh. Yeah.
350.
Yeah.
Ooh, we'll see.
It's good. Because you taxi 400.
Huh.
Me only 350.
My book says 200.
No, because it's good price.
Because 200 sounds like good price.
Because my car here.
Wait, no. Your car's here?
Yeah. No, you know, you don't walk in. No.
It's not in the parking garage. It's right here.
I think we're going to talk to some people, see how much their rates go for, and then we'll
please.
Come back to
yeah,
you.
Please.
Yes.
Yeah.
And what was your name?
John.
That is
John.
That is amazing.
Yes. His name is John. Awesome.
Look at that. Ubud Center, 250.
Right there.
250.
John, I'm very disappointed in you. All right, Sean, what's happening right now?
So we just befriended our cab driver, Adi, and it turns out that the number one most popular American band in Bali is Green Day.
Thank you.
So, of course, the best thing to do after we find that out is to have a jam session in the car. Let's do it.
Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps setting up. I think I'm cracking up. Am I just paranoid? Am I just a...
We made it finally. Beautiful Ubud. Look at this. This is just incredible. Unbelievably gorgeous. Rice growing right here, right next to this beautiful supermarket.
Hello from Ubud, Bali. We're just chilling out in this amazing palace of a hotel. And I currently feel horrible. We got to document these low points. I have kind of like headache going on, a little stomach queasiness, some body ache. It's not all fun and games, kids.
Looking for some Gatorade.
and water. I feel like I can vomit in any second right now. Got Gatorade. This place is bumping fucking gamelan music. I love gamelan music, but I swear to God, it's coming out of that huge ass speaker right there. We're trying to keep the traveling spirit alive. Watching some Walter Mitty over here. Alright, so Todd and I just awoke from the depths of hell, aka food poisoning. And so.
Literally a full day, 24 hours.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And I don't know about you, I'm feeling exponentially better.
Brand new day.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I have to get some coconut water from a local place here, a local cafe. 3 days left of the trip to make it count.
Cheers.
Cheers. So we're here at the Royal Temple in Ubud, Bali, and the royal family apparently lives here. And the funny thing is, I'm pretty sure that our hotel is nicer than this place.
Pretty similar. Here's Sean on the royal dance floor in the Ubud Palace. Here it is, MTV Cribs, Ubud edition.
Come on, this is my favorite part. So right here, I got this in a Kuta right here. After a long night, drinking some arak. Oh man. Julia Roberts, eat your heart out. We're at the Yoga Barn in Ubud, Bali. Written in papyrus, of course, very original. And I thought our workouts were pretty tough.
Come help.
So, when I see tropical waters or a tropical island on like a desktop, I always think it's like doctored up or Photoshop or enhanced in some way. But come here and the water really is that green. It's crazy. Hashtag no filter. It's been a rough past couple days. So Todd and I are rewarding ourselves with a stay at this place. And of course, the first book that we see here. Indonesian alarm clocks for sale.
Hey guys.
Hey everybody.
Here we are on the flight home, last leg of the trip.
And this is the moment you guys have all been waiting for. Todd and I, we're gonna make out. We're gonna summarize the trip. Okay, so the rest of that footage is actually pretty boring. And the reason is because A, Todd and I are super exhausted from the trip. B, we're trying to keep it down because we're on an airplane and there are other people around. And C, we're a little bit inebriated. What we essentially talk about are the 7 travel virtues that I have. And we wanted to use this trip to show examples of those virtues. But I'm thinking that I'll just devote an entire video just to that. In the meantime, I think I'll just play guitar while we fade to black. And 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.